Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and this week it's all about labels and how to make your labels more effective. Now, when I'm working in my coaching business, what I notice is quite a few people have so many labels and they add the labels religiously to those tasks and then never use those labels. And when that happens, it means your labels are not very effective. So what I want to do in this lesson is I want to give you a few label ideas that you can use that will help you to really focus in on the work that matters at the right time. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this lesson, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. Yep, that one. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account now and I will show you some really good labels that you can use. Okay, so the reason why I'm doing this video is because of this week's Todoist office hours with Brenna from Todoist. She's in charge of the marketing. And she went through how she uses her Todoist. And there was a few ideas that I got from there that I really would like to share with you, because I think this is one way of really solving that problem of overwhelming lists. Now, let me explain that a little bit more. Normally, when we come in, most people are working from their today view. Now, when you open up your today view, you end up with a list like this. Now, this is not actually a really good place to start the day. It's actually a horrible place to start the day because it's like, what am I going to do? And, you know, I can go in there now with the new sort and I can create some sort by all sorts of things. So I can group by, in fact, here I might group by label, for example, and sort by, let's say, priority. And that's kind of great. And I can go and sort. And so I've got my personal at the top. Then I've got my calls, email, closing, finance team, work. You know, great. But it still is an incredibly long list, which to me is not a great place to start the day. So what Brenna does, and I think this is just a genius idea, is to separate out the day. So if we're talking about Monday to Friday, you know, during the Monday, you are going to be at work at some point. And on that day, you're also going to be at home someday. So while you're at work, and this is classic GTD system, while you're at work, you do not need to see your home tasks. Now, it's true, you could be working from home, but you're supposed to be working. So what Brenna has done is she created a label called at work. So here I've got at work and a label called personal or something like that. And then you can create a filter to show today and at work. So exactly, that's exactly the filter. If I show you the filter here, the filter is very, very simple. It's just today and at work. So if I edit the filter, you can see here's the filter query, today and at work. And obviously for the personal one, it will be today and at personal. So that's how you set up the filter for this. So essentially, when you start the day, all you have to do is say, where am I? Am I working or am I at home? So let's say I'm working. So we've got 19 tasks for today, and that just looks incredibly overwhelming. But when you hit that, you're today at work, this is the list that you are going to be working from. So today and at work. So this is really, really straightforward. Now, I've taken this to another level, and you can do this yourself. You can take this to another level, which is also to add email and calls. So let's just say a lot of your work requires email. So while I'm in this list, I don't have to go anywhere else. I don't need to go hunting for the label. All I need to do is click on email, and that's now going to bring up all my email list. Now, another quick way of doing this, by the way, and I'm going to do this blind, but is today in the Finder, is today and at calls. So you can do that and hit the return, and there you go. I've only got one call to do today. So you can actually create a filter from, and again, the filter would just simply be today and at calls. And the same again, I can go in here and type in today. Well, I've got to type it correctly, today and at email. Hit return, and I get my email that's all got to be done today. Now, again, you can create these filters, and I have actually done that, and you can actually put those filters in here. Now, what I've also done is, so let's say I'm at work, so I'm doing that, blah, blah, blah. This is where I'm going to spend most of my day. I'm working. I'm not meant to be doing anything else. I'm meant to be working. So this is my work for the day, 9 tasks. I can focus in on just getting on with those. If I want to go a little bit deeper, sure, I can go into my email filter, or I can go into my calls filter. And then let's say I finish work, it gets to like 5-6 o'clock, and I finish work for the day. I can then switch over to the next view, which is today and at home. So I want to exercise, check my bank balance, do my daily planning, take the dog for a walk, and continue cleaning up Evernote. So it just breaks down this overwhelming list, which is a horrible, horrible place to go into when you start the day. You just say, okay, where am I? And as I say, this is classic GTD stuff, that you go in and you go, right, I'm at work. This is all I focus on right now. So it really helps you to focus in. Then you get home, you click on my at home, and you go into your home list. And doing this from your phone, by the way, doesn't fill up your phone screen either. Now, I also have that closing down, which I mentioned in an episode a couple of weeks ago, which is also my closing down. So for the day, so I can close down this. For those of you who missed that, the filter for that is simply I have a label called closing. And again, it's just today and at closing. So those are some really, really useful filters, that some labels that you can use, but you want to try and reduce the number of labels that you want. So I see people with at 2 minutes, at quick wins, you know, that kind of label. It's just more than you need to add. So this means that when you go to your processing, I've got a couple of items in here. So what's this one? So confirm Jenny is ready to start on the 3rd. So I know immediately that's at work. So I can just go into there, type in at W, comes at work. Takes less than a second to do that. When do I want to do that? I'm going to do that tomorrow. And that's really essentially it. I want to move that to my this week, because obviously on the time sector system, that's being done this week. And that's now been done. It's got the label for tomorrow and at work. I've got one here, follow up Jeff, required. So schedule that. That needs to be done next week. So I'll do that on Monday. I'm going to add the label. Of course, it's at work. So I can just tap that one, and that's done. And that's it. It's done. So I didn't add the project. So let's just go in there and just add the project. It's going to be next week. So let's do that. And that's job done. Everything is done. I've cleared my inbox. Now, that was just 2. And if I wasn't talking at the same time, that would have taken me less than 5 seconds to do that. And so that's the whole point of trying to build a productivity system that is fast and intuitive. It's just really, really quick. If I had 10s and 20, 30 labels, I'm having to pause that moment longer to think about what label to add. So one thing I would give you is, whenever it comes to your labels, regularly review your labels. If you're going into your labels list here and you find that you haven't got, like I've got down here, Chris, Fred, and Nicola, which I'm going to show you in a second. These ones here, they've all got numbers by them. So I'm obviously using them. But the question I would ask is, am I really using them? Do I use these labels? Are they part of a filter, or are they part? Do I actually just use the label? Either way, if you're not using them, delete them. You can always add them back later, but try and keep your labels list as short as possible. That's probably the biggest tip I can give you. Now, one more thing that came up from Brenna's office hours video was, she has a project called HR, and I absolutely love this. Now, this is for those of you who are working with a team. If you have a team of people that you work with as a manager, you are a manager and your direct reports, then what you want to do is create this kind of HR parent folder, and then you create one-to-one, like Carl and Chris, one-to-one Carl and Fred, one-to-one Carl and Nicola. Inside each project, you have 2 sections, and this is brilliant. I'm going to link to that video that Brenna and Todoist shared, because you'll learn so much, particularly if you're working in a team environment with your Todoist. You have agenda items here, and you have action items. Now, what you want to be doing is, in my case, I am Carl, but what I want to do is I need to send a link to Chris. I want to share this this project with Chris. So I can add share. So I don't have anyone I share because I have no friends or colleagues. But if you were sharing with your colleagues, you can just tap on that and you can then collaborate with your friends. Sorry, with your colleague. And you can ask them to actually add things that they would like to discuss with you. Now, during the meeting, during the discussion, you then add the action items and who is responsible. Is it you or is it Chris? But here, this is the area you want to encourage Chris to add, things that he wants to talk to you about. Same with here, with like Nicola. Again, if I want have a one-to-one scheduled with Nicola, say next week, I can send this project to Nicola and say, please add whatever you want to discuss to the agenda. Of course, I will be adding my stuff. And then we have an agenda that we've actually built for ourselves. I love that idea. And if you want to learn more about that, have a look at the video, which I've linked below, because you will learn so much about that. And that, speaking of which, then allows you to create a label for your colleague. So I've got here, Chris, Fred, and Nicola. These are my direct reports. And I can then just add any items in there. They can become holding. And I would put them in my long-term and at hold. The beauty of it is when it gets to saying, oh, I've got a meeting with Nicola tomorrow, I can then go into my label for Nicola. And I can say, oh, these are the things that I want to talk to Nicola about. And I can move them into the agenda. So there you go. Those are just a few things that I picked up from that video. It was brilliant, and I really recommend that you spend some time this weekend having a watch of it, because you can learn so much about real world Todoist use. I think you'll get so much benefit from it. Okay, well, thank you very much for watching this video, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.